Hi everyone, this is Jim from JimShapedCoding, and I really recommend you guys to watch this video if you are already a Python programmer and using classes, because I'm going to challenge you with one of the most useful functions that I use whenever I program with classes. So stay tuned and let's start. So we are going to start with a short example so I can explain my point to you guys. So we got a class here, and the class is called car, and it's got one required property that you have to pass it whenever you initialize an instance, and the parameter's name is color, as you see in the double underscore init function. And right after that, I created three cars, meaning three instances of a car class, and I called them car1, car2, and car3, and they have different colors with blue, green, and red. Now, my goal is to explain you how you can get all the instances of a class in one shot. So I'm going to write now one of the really repeatedly useful functions whenever you code with a class. So in order to accomplish that, as you see, I have a file that called car.py right there, and I opened another empty file that called class underscore utilities, so I can import the function from here and use it in my car file. So we will start to write this function, and it's going to be called get all instances. And as a required parameter here, I'll pass of class to define you that I really need a class name to get back all the instances. So what I want to start with is defining a list that I want to store all the instances in a list and return that as a list. So I like to do a underscore right there just because comfort reasons, nothing special. And we will continue from here. So there is a module called GC in Python that I will use here, and it's really a shortcut for garbage collector, because this is kind of a module that it does the workaround in order to your Python code would be look more nicer. So this goes like this. So I need to iterate through all the objects of garbage collector, and I want to check if there is an instance he found in the class that passed in here. So what I really going to do is iterate over the objects in garbage collector.getObjects. This is the built-in function that does that. Excuse me. Great. And I'm going to use the built-in if is instance function and pass it as an object that I'm iterating here, and he's going to check if an object has an instance in the class that I'm passing right there in the function. So if this does true, I want to append that to the empty list I created in the first line of a function. So instances dot append to the list the object that I iterate through. So the last line will be for sure returning the instances. So this is pretty much the six lines of function that I already put that as a built-in module in my Python environment, so I could access it anytime I want to use the get all instances function. So let's go back to our car.py file, and I'm going to import this function by from class utilities, since it's in the same directory. Import get all instances. This is the function we wrote a minute ago. So let's try to use it. First, I want to store with all cars equals to get all instances of the car class. Make sure you don't pass in the parentheses here, it will confuse the function. And now what I want to do is iterate through all the instances, for example, and try to do something like for car in all cars, let's get all the colors back. So what I have to do to is access that property, and I can do that by car.color, and let's print it. Great, and now if I execute this, you know that I will get back blue, green and red, because this is the three colors of the instances. So I have another point how you can accomplish the goal of getting all instances of a class in another simple way. So let's delete all these lines of code in order for me to explain you. Let's say that we want to have now 100 cars. And what I'm going to do to make this as the shortest as possible is obviously to use the range method, and it's going to iterate 100 times. So for car in range 100, I want to create an instance of a car, and let's say I want all the colors in the red color. Great, so this will create 100 instances of a car, but the problem in this code is that the instances are not stored anywhere, and to do that I can create something like car instances that it will store all the instances of the car class. So instead of doing just car red, what I can do is car instances dot append the initialization of the car with the red color 100 times. So whenever I want to access, for example, the car in the 8th index or something, I can do that in a really easy way. So to make sure you guys understood this, I just want to print you the each car that I just stored in the car instances. So let's print it and see our output. Great, so as you see, we have all the 100 car objects right there, but if I want to access the 8th index car right there, I can do that also. So if I'm going to print this, I'm just going to get back an object, a randomly object of the car that it's stored as the 8th index right there. So this is also a way you can get back all your instances storing in a list before. This will save you time also. So I really thank you guys that you watched this one, and I hope this will help you before you're going to write your next class in your Python project. I will see you guys in the next time. Don't forget to subscribe and like my videos. See you in the next one.